Taylor of 32 The Ridge, Orpington, Kent, do solemnly and sincerely declare and affirm that I will well and truly serve our Sovereign Lady the Queen in the office of Constable without favour or affection, malice or ill will, and that I will, to the best of my power, cause the peace to be kept and preserved, and prevent all offences against the persons and properties of Her Majesty's subjects, and that while I continue to hold the said office, I will, to the best of my skill and knowledge, discharge all the duties thereof, faithfully according to law.
All units Lima Golf, lost or stolen, a blue Datsun Cherry, new uniform P Papa M Mike 575 S Sierra, since 1215, Lancaster Avenue.
Just about enough of her. What was she kept moaning on about for?
Because I was playing on my skateboard.
I've never heard such a thing. I've got to complain about this.
Just a moment. Now, what's the problem?
Well, right, girls, that's all the information we have. Hopefully it'll be of some use to you. Okay? Bye-bye. Good luck with the project. Hello, have you found this bloke yet?
Did you have any luck with that van?
No, none at all, Terry. Been there three times this term, mate. And think,
just carry on keeping an
eye. Yeah, sure, we'll do.
Court is court. Harry's at court tomorrow on his week leave. Money like hell.
Can't take a joke. You shouldn't have joined, mate.
All right, Harry.
Well, I told him, because of the condition of the car, I'd better leave it there. So I said, right, officer, call me a taxi. So I did. I said, you're a taxi, sir.
I see that blue Triumph parked outside Jack Shear's pad with a foreign-looking bloke sitting in it. He was there for some time.
Well, I'll tell you what, every little helps. Can you put it in the diary record books? I'm off to the private.
OK.
I've taken all the statements in this assault case. And I've been to see the victim. He no longer wishes to take any action.
Well, that's a great waste of time, isn't it?
Put your appointments away, then. Make yourself comfortable. 341.
Sarge.
You're on Panda 43. I want you to pick up the inspector at Brixton at 4:30 p.m. and bring him back here. 592.
Sarge.
You'll be on 15 patrol. Take your refreshments at 6:15 p.m. I want you to go to St Martin's Estate, where we've had a number of complaints of children and youths causing trouble with the residents. 724.
Sarge.
You'll be on 17 patrol. When you go out, call on Mrs Watson at 63 Ivy Mount Road. She has information on the recent vehicle thefts in the area. 226.
Sarge.
You're on Panda 44. I want you to keep a good eye on the area of Salters Hill and the park in view of the recent handbag snatch. It could be the same man as involved at Streatham Hill on Streatham section. The collator can give you some information on this man.
Yes, it would appear that this bloke's been working Norbury section as well as Streatham and appears to come on to us last night. Streatham have managed to send us across a photo fit and some information, which I hope you'll take when you leave the parade.
Who's that then, Rod?
He's been nicked, so he's in the charge room at the moment. No, not wanted. Previous for violence. Can you take this into the charge room, please?
All right, you've heard what the PC's got to say about this. What have you got to say?
What about my head, eh? What about my head? He banged it against the wall.
We've sent for the doctor already.
About time, too. I'm bleeding like a stuck pig.
I understand you tried to run away.
Look, mate, what do I want to do with that boy? He'd done nothing.
If you call threatening someone with this outside the White Swan nothing, you'd better think again, mister. And also, see, you've got a record for violence.
Not this time. That sod suddenly turned on me.
Look, the officer's already admitted that your head hit the wall when you tried to run away.
That's his side of it, isn't it?
I'm sure you're going to tell me your side of it.
I'm going to do more than that, mate. I'm going to complain, official.
Of course you are. And I'm going to give you a leaflet explaining you how to go about it. As if you didn't already know.
Right, well, here's what happened. First of all, that isn't mine.
Just a moment. We'll do my business first.
What's that?
Your charge sheet. The charge against you, Sean Lawton, is that on Thursday the 6th of April, West O'Hill, South East 19, without lawful authority or reasonable excuse, having with you in a public place an offensive weapon, there's a knuckle duster. That's contrary to Section 1, Subsection 1 of the Prevention of Crime Act 1953.
Come on, man, the knuckle duster wasn't mine. I told you, it was the other geezers. He dropped it. I just picked it up to have a look at it.
He's charging,
not me.
I didn't
start. He didn't put me in trouble all night. He's charging what he's lying about witnesses, you know.
Shut up.
You think, pig?
You see, there are police stations all over London, most of which are open all day and all night, and anyone can go in at any time for help or advice, or just to say hello, if you like. Now, can anyone tell me how many policemen or women there are in London?
22 million.
Ah, there'd be no crime at all if we had that many. I think you've added a few too many noughts.
22,000.
Right, 22,000. And each policeman on duty has to look after about 3,500 people.
And I thought, well, that's funny, because he came last week.
He wasn't the regular window cleaner then, dear.
Oh, no, I didn't recognise him. He hasn't been here before.
Never seen him before?
No. And then he drove away and I thought, oh, I suppose he's gone for a cup of tea.
Yeah.
But he left the ladder there, and when I came back, it was still there, and that's what I thought was so suspicious.
You're certainly right, dear. There's no window cleaner. They've had a break-in, I'm afraid.
Oh, dear. Poor Mrs. Atkins.
But you should be here more often to catch him at it.
If any of you see him or anything suspicious, can you ring us?
Yeah.
Thanks very much.
Bye.
Yeah. Bye-bye. Excuse me.
Yes?
I didn't want to say anything in front of the others, but there's a chap like the one in the photo that's moved in with Mrs. Jarman.
Number 60?
Yes. She's been in trouble herself before.
Fine. We'll look into it. Thanks very much.
Bye-bye.
I'm not chasing you.
Oh, you're just testing us, man. I mean, you always hassle us. You're not hassling them next door. You don't go poking in their front rooms like you're doing here. I mean, what's it about? You know, it's just because we're
scoring. Well, I'm the home beat officer. I introduce myself to everyone on this patch.
Well, go and introduce yourself somewhere else, because we don't need you at all here, you know?
Well, if I get any complaints about noise or behaviour, then I'll be down on you. But if you've got any problems, then I'll come
well,
and
no
see you.
Well, no one's going to hear us over that lot out there, are they? You know, they're just demolishing the area.
Well, I'll
right,
be up
you
there.
You know? Good. Sort of.
What is the pig want this time?
Oh, well, we didn't fit in his plastic box.
Oscar Lima 1-2, Oscar Lima 1-2 from Oscar. Dulwich Wood Park, junction with College Road, southeast 1-9. Serious personal injury accident. Ends origin 1700. Oscar, over.
Well, we've got two. There's one over here, I think he's had it, and this one here isn't far from it.
Have you called for an ambulance?
Yeah, I've called
that. It's coming, yeah.
Right.
What have you got?
We've got
John, can you help me with this seatbelt, please? We'll have to unfasten from the back.
If it wasn't for the fact that they'd killed my dog, I wouldn't have called the police in at all.
But why not?
Well, isn't it obvious? Nothing appears to have been taken. I just don't want any fuss.
Oh, I see. It's all right if they break in. As long as you don't steal anything, you kill your dog. Is that right?
Look, don't you be clever with me, laddie. I just happen to know your divisional commander.
No doubt you do. The CID officer's arrived. If you wait there a moment, I'm going to have a word with him.
Very well.
Hello, Dixie. What have we got here?
There's a funny one here. I've been a few words with him. I can't make head nor tail of it.
I quite agree. I probably shouldn't have called him in the first place. Yes, but the dog's dead now and we're stuck with it.
Well, you know, we've both got to be a little bit careful with this man, don't
we? Yes, I know, Bacon.
Well, you take Trevor outside to look at the dog and I'll go and have a word with our friend.
Right, okay.
Yes, okay, Jack, I agree. I'll call you back.
Right, what's going on here? Do you know what it's all about?
Well, it looks as though somebody's been trying to get at me, officer.
Get at you? What do you mean, get at you?
Yeah, this bloke's into everything. He does a bit of fencing, pornography. Got nothing on him. He does nothing on this ground, huh?
Sounds a tasty villain.
Yes, he is.
Oh, and there was one thing. One of my neighbours did actually see a car driving away. Yes. It was a blue Triumph.
Yes, did he get the number?
Well, I think he got part of it. I think it was a TCF.
You nosy old cow! You haven't got enough to do, have you? You go and look out of your cut or something.
Come away from that window and come and sit over here.
It knows she falls downstairs, doesn't she?
Enough trouble as it is.
Come on, with enough time until you come over here.
You've hit her again, haven't you?
Hitting
me! Just sit down there and keep quiet. Sort this thing out. We're good now.
Take it away. I don't want to hear it or see it anymore. Coming in people's houses telling them what to do. Take it away.
Hi there, duty officer. WPC. And a divisional surgeon, please.
I think it's criminal. Every time you let your cat out, it comes into my garden. Look at the mess it makes. I'm fed up with it.
Go where it likes. I know the law. I've got a book here. I've read about it. And cats are allowed to go anywhere.
Right, okay, so now quiet down, both of you, please.
But
now listen. Well, there are two sorts of law. Criminal law, civil law.
What are you saying about
cats,
my cat?
Now, cats, gardens, that's civil law.
That's nothing to do with police. Now, if you want to do anything about it, you'll have to go and see a solicitor. Here. Now, just quiet down, please.
All units, Lima Golf, Norwood Road, in the last 5 minutes on foot, direction not known. Attention to two West Indian youths, aged approximately 17, no further description at present. Alleged concern, theft of two transistor radios, Lima Golf, over.
Hey, you two, come over here. Just a minute, hold on, and you. What have you got there?
Why pulling the scrapper? Why sussing us?
Because we're black.
Look, I don't care if you're black, white or purple. You two answer the description of two coloured lads that have just seen stealing some property and I want to know what you've got in that parcel.
No rights, copper. You ain't even got a search warrant.
Look, son, I don't need a warrant to stop and search anyone. Now, what have you got in there?
Just showing the Fleming parcel.
That's fine, lovely. You bought it, you've got a receipt. There's no need for all that hassle about stopping us and sus, and because we're black, all I wanted to do was check. Now, there's nothing in it. There's no sweat, no hard feelings, is there?
We're from Gypsy Hill Police Station. We'd like a word with you.
What's that about?
About a handbag snatch.
Lima Golf from 4-4. VD on the move, please. Over. Yes, it's the new uniform, a Y Yankee, R Romeo, 511 F.
Over. Message received, 4-4. Stand by.
4-4 from Lima Golf. This is a lost or stolen from East Dulwich since the 23rd of March.
Motor vehicle 324 refers. Lima Golf out.
Yeah, Lima Golf from 4-4. I'm Bloomhall Road towards Hawk Road. I'm going to try and give them a call up in Hawk Road. Over.
Excuse me, sir. Is this your vehicle?
No, it's mate, isn't it?
And what's your mate's name?
Neil.
Neil what?
Neil Freeman.
Well, sir, this car was reported stolen only yesterday.
Don't we contact him now?
No, my dear. Haven't forgotten you at all. I appreciate this is your second call you've made. Yeah, as soon as I have an officer available, I'll send him off down to you.
Can I help you?
Yes, I received this from the solicitor and I just don't understand it.
Let me have a look and see what we can do for you.
Yeah, he was last arrested in September. Yep, okay. Keep in touch. Cheers. Fan are you looking for, Terry?
Well, I don't know who I'm looking for yet, Fred, to be quite honest with you. This is the loser of that dead dog this morning.
Oh, yeah?
He's got plenty of form himself, as you can see. He reckons he was set up by somebody, I don't know who by. One of the neighbours took the part index number of a car outside, TCF with a 6.
TCF? Hang on a minute. One of the lads had something near this morning about that. Yeah, TCF 656 in November. A blue Triumph. It was parked outside Jack Shearer's place.
Jack Shearer? Now, that makes sense of the whole thing, doesn't it? If he got somebody in to do the job for him, because this one's crossed his path, I'll do a check on the computer straight away.
The doctor's been to examine a prisoner who alleged assault. Mm-hmm. And a stray dog brought in this morning has had a litter of pups.
Silly bitch.
The orphan's box, £28.30.
Saucy, that's very good.
Plus a couple of buttons and two beer cap pulls.
Oh, well, you always get those. Better a few more satisfied customers than not.
I see that you're 2 weeks behind.
Yes, sir, I'm being it tomorrow.
See that you do, and should the landlord try to throw you out?
That's not the lady's handbag. I ran across the park this morning.
That was this morning. What took you so long to come in?
I had to go and get my pension and go round the shops, and I was on the way home when I come in to tell you about it.
Right, if you'd just like to wait there a moment, sir.
Thank you.
I think we've got a witness to that handbag snatch this morning.
Oh, good. Put him in the waiting room, will you, and call the CID.
Okay,
go and have a look at the duty statement.
If you'd like to come into the waiting room, sir, I'll get someone to take a statement for me.
Come on, get your hands off. I've done nothing at all. Get your hands off.
Who have you got on duty this afternoon? Two big cars, four walking, one time off, two annual leave, one sick, one on the robbery squad, one on the burglary squad. Pin court. What's he in court with?
It's that not guilty drugs job. It's been on and off for weeks now.
You handed him the packet containing the drugs referred to and said, cop that lot, Sonny. That will wipe the smile from your face.
No, sir. As I've already...
Allow me to finish, please. Is that not, in fact, the true version of what happened? And before you answer, I feel I must remind you that you are on oath.
Thank you, sir. I know that I am on oath. Your Worship, that is not true. When I searched the accused, as I've already stated, I found the drugs in his jacket pocket, which at the time he readily admitted were his.
Ah, yes, officer, but this alleged admission is another matter strongly denied by my client. While on this subject, is it not true that my client has made a formal complaint against you, stating that you place these drugs in his possession, and also fabricated verbal admissions? And is it not also true that this matter is being investigated by a senior officer?
Yes, sir.
What's 430 doing on a CID attachment?
It's on that rape case, the one where the woman opened the door to the bogus gas meter man.
Good morning, madam. I'm from Gypsy Hill Police Station.
Hello.
It's all right, love. Nothing to worry about. Just a routine inquiry.
Hello? The old lady downstairs is sick. She never goes out.
Is anybody calling on her?
No, not as far as I know.
Okay, thanks very much. I'll call back later, see what can be done.
I see Johnson's A to A.
Yes, a big demonstration came up at short notice.
That's about his third one in a fortnight now. He'll be thinking we don't like him.
Who's your first aid?
If I never go on another demo, it'll be too soon.
Yeah, I know what you mean. But you're only holding out now for your compensation.
You watch it, I shall be on night duties next week, checking overtime.
Oh, God.
Go home in time, that's a joke. Hit rock bottom that ages ago. Tell you what, though, my wife's happier now. I'm home a bit more often.
You want to kick your wife, Abby?
Helen, CID,
watch
it downstairs straight away.
God, just give me tea.
Come on, you're going to take the old lady's handbag. How does she get the injuries then?
No way, no way. I'll grab the old woman's
handbag. Look, we've got one witness who saw you actually hit her in the face.
No way. I'll grab the handbag and that was it.
I've done a check on the car and it apparently belongs to an Antonio Morelli.
You want to know about him?
Well, I've done a CRO check. Those are his previous.
Boy, they're a bit heavy.
As you can see, he's wanted for a serious assault at Stoke Newington. And he's also got previous for assault on police.
So we got him linked with a possible burglary and wanted for a GBH. We got some CID staff. Can you assist us at all?
Yes, sure. How many do you want?
Knowing the setup down there, half a dozen.
You'll be lucky. I've only got five on altogether. I'll give you two, maybe three.
We've got to go down there heavy-handed, you know.
It could be a bit of a rough house, sir.
Well, there you are, ladies and gentlemen. That is what we were talking about earlier on. But just before you go, a final word from our crime prevention officer.
As I said before, the first principle of police is the prevention of crime. And this includes offering you free advice on the security of your home and asking you to contact us if you see anything or anyone suspicious.
Yeah, that's all very well, but what's the use? You'd only let the thieving buggers off.
Well, I'd like to take up that point, if I may. You've put your finger on something which confuses a lot of people. First of all, we in the police do not make the laws of the land, and we do not punish people who break the laws. Our job is to see that society works peacefully according to law, to prevent crimes if we can, to arrest people who can't live within the law, and to present evidence in front of a court. But Laws are made by Parliament and punishments are decided by magistrates and judges. And both of these are completely separate from the police.
You must understand that we have to establish whether he hit you accidentally or deliberately.
Well, what difference does it make?
It makes a lot of difference to what we may charge him with.
Well, I don't care what you charge. It's obvious, isn't it? Look, I'm injured. Look, I'm walking along, just mind my own business. And he jumps up from behind us. He tries to grab my bag. I mean, should I just give it to him? It's my bag. If he had kept his hands to himself, I wouldn't be here. I wouldn't have to go through all this. I don't care what you charge him with.
Look, we have to charge him with the right offence, otherwise he may get away with it at court.
Charge him?
You just sit here. I'll go and get you a cup of tea.
Thank you.
Taking a statement from a victim.
Now, look at the time, my friend. Your time of reporting is between 6 and 9pm. Do you understand?
Yeah. Well, I got holed up like on the way here. My car broke down.
These are the conditions of your bail. If you value your freedom, don't let it happen again.
Yeah, I know that, but I can't help it if my car broke down now, can I?
OK, I'll overlook it this time. Off you go.
OK. Cheers, man. Bye.
Look, we want to buy some of your lads tonight.
Yes, sir.
If you have a look, Mr. Duke, I'll tell you all about it.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Guess what? I've got all the details here in front of me.
We're out tomorrow.
Right, where are you on?
I'm in for refreshments, sir.
Not now, you're not. What I want you to do, get a quick cup of tea, then come straight down, see the CID. They'll want your help to search some premises. All right?
Yeah. OK.
Rodney, what I want you to do is get Panda 4, 3 and 4.
Your boy witnessed some use stealing from a motor vehicle.
Shut off! He's seen nothing, he's a witness to nothing. And you can't make him either.
Yeah, but he doesn't necessarily have to attend court. He can make a written statement.
All 3 and 4-4, Casewick Road, junction with Thornlaw Road, meet D.S. Jones and assist search of premises. Lima Golf, over.
Attacked. 724, state your location. Graham, call the chief inspector. 724, where are you?
Sounds like a lot of growth. I'm not just walked into. Who's that on there?
Oh, it's Stuart.
With a shout like that, Jeff, I expect you want to go and help the lads out. And we'll sit it out here on Chummy, OK?
Yeah.
Have you heard any more, Rod?
No, sir.
Look, where the hell is he, Tank?
Well, this is the problem, sir. We just can't figure it out.
Lima Golf from 723, over.
Look, get him off the air and get everybody else to stay off the air so as if he's about, at least he can come in.
Yes, sir. Should we get all the lads back to the station, sir?
No, look, tell them to stay exactly where they are. Somebody may be very close to them, wherever he is.
All units from Lima Golf, maintain your positions and radio silence.
You curious bastard!
What's that?
Come on, go, John. No, come on, it's not our affair.
No, come on.
I think we've given this long enough now.
Right.
OK, we're moving. You and Alan round the back and I'll take it round the front with Terry, OK?
OK.
Fair enough, let's go.
Somebody call, for pity's sake.
There's probably no one around.
There's always somebody around. All they've got to do is call us.
Well, it's a waste of time.
No.
It's an absolute waste of time.
Shut up, woman. I can't do nothing.
You don't have to get involved, John. Don't give your name. Just say where we are.
Right, East Place. Get both pandas down there straight away. Graham, get on the phone, get an ambulance down.
I want these villains.
Get Panda 4-3 to come in from Auckland Hill.
The dog's no problem at all. Christ, what's that? Tell Bill. No.
They're into us.
No, it's all right. They're going away.
Well, I'm going. Well, the going's good.
There's nothing to do with us at all.
Okay, Brady, stay where you are. Okay, take it easy. Calm down.
Take that, you pig.
Lee McGull from Panda 3. There's three men running up Auckland Hill. I'm after them now.
Received. Panda 4, did you get that? Where are you?
We're turning into Auckland Hill. There they are. We see them. We're getting out now. Lee McGull from Panda 4. We've got three. One's got blood all over his shirt. We're bringing them in now.
Message received.